Next topic, put the heading decoders. See, whenever you are preparing for exam, if it is a conventional exam, okay, whenever you want to remember whatever the some paragraph or anything is there, you will remember with some keyword, right? That is nothing but what? Coding. Okay. So, at the exam, okay, with the help of that particular keyword, you will elaborately explain, right? Pages after pages. So, that is called as decoding. So, here, this decoder functionality is what? Decoding. Here, you will be having the coded information, okay? Based on the coded information, it will decode. Okay, similarly, encoder, it will be coded. We will represent in terms of zeros and ones. Okay, just like in the first chapter, we have discussed various codes like 8421, XS3, like that, right? So there, in order to represent the decimal numbers, we are using bits. We are having, for a single digit, we can represent 10 digits, 0 to 9. Okay, we are having 10 values. Okay, since we are having 10 values, okay, those 10 values we are representing with 4 bits in 8421 or XS3 code. Okay, whatever the 10 values we are having, all those 10 values we are representing with 4 bits. That is nothing but encoding. Okay, here decoding. Decoding means here we will be having coded information, we will decode into the normal, like that. Here we are having set of inputs, here we are having set of outputs. Okay, I will choose n and 2 power n. Which one will be the inputs, which one will be the outputs? Yeah, n is the inputs, 2 power n is the outputs, correct. So here we are having number of inputs is n, number of outputs is 2 power n. So the size of the decoder is n to 2 power n. N to 2 power n. Decoder is a combination circuit which performs the decoding operation. Next point. At any time, one of the 2 power n outputs will be equal to 1 based on the code available at the input. So if you consider n value 2, then you will get 2 to 4 decoder. If you consider n value 3, you will get 3 to 8 decoder. Substitute n value 4, you will get 4 to 16 decoder. First, let us start with 2 to 4 decoder, right? First, draw the block diagram. Here, n value is 2. That means you will be having 2 inputs and here you will be having 4 outputs. I am considering AB as the inputs and outputs as D0 to D3. D0, D1, D2, D3. 2 to 4 decoder, n value is 2. So here 2 square is 4. AB are the inputs, D0 to D3 are the outputs. Now let us write the truth table for 2 to 4 decoder. Here inputs are A and B. Outputs are D0 to D3. You can write either of the order, D0 to D3 or D3 to D0. There is no issue. So here I am having 2 inputs. So represent with 4 combinations of zeros and ones. 00, 01, 10, 11. So here the coded information will be available. Based on the coded information, at any time a particular output will be 1. Okay. So just for easy understanding, see, whatever the decimal equivalent here you will get, that one I have put as a suffix here. 00 is nothing but 0. 01 is nothing but 1. 10 is nothing but 2. 11 is nothing but 3. Okay. So that means if 00 is available here, okay, then D0 will be 1. D0 will be 1. Remaining outputs will be 0. See here, either input side or output side, everything we have to represent in terms of zeros and ones only. Right? So that's why here I have considered 2 inputs. Okay, that means you are having 2 bit code. Okay. So based on that, we can represent 4 outputs. Okay. If 00 is available, then D0 will be 1. Okay. If 01 is available, then D1 will be available. D1 will be 1. Next. If 10 is available, then D2 will be 1. Next. If 11 is available, then D3 will be 1. See, whatever the coded information here available. Okay. Just write the decimal equivalent. Okay. So that's decimal number I have put just for reference as the suffix value here. Okay. If 00 is available, then D0 will be 1. Remaining bits will be zeros. If 01 is available, then D1 will be 1. If 10 is available, D2 will be 1. Like that. Yeah, if you want, you can define. There is no issue. See, in the beginning class also, in the first class also I have mentioned. There I have considered 4 levels. L0, L1, L2, L3. There, L0 is nothing but 00, L1 is nothing but 01, L2 is nothing but 10, L3 is nothing but 11. Okay, whatever the assumption you are considering at the input side, when you are getting that at the receiver, you have to consider in the same way in order to get back from the digital to analog. Wherever suppose L3 is there, I will represent as 11 like that. Suppose here if you are considering say 00 as D3 as 1, okay, then you have to consider the same notation throughout. So whatever the notation you are considering at the encoding side, you have to consider at the opposite as the decoder, at the decoding side, like that. So here for easy understanding, whatever the suffix number I have put, those are the decimal numbers, right? Whatever the code here available, the corresponding decimal equivalent I am considering for easy understanding. Now tell me the outputs. What is D0? D0 is getting 1 for when both A and B are equal to 0. That means A bar B bar, right? Similarly, D1 is getting 1 when A is 0 and B is 1. That means A bar B. Like that you can write. D2 equal to AB bar. D3 equal to AB. Now draw the circuit diagram. You require AND gates, inverters. Here we are having the outputs D0, D2, D3 as A bar B bar, A bar B, AB bar, AB. Okay. So here D0 equal to A bar B bar. That means I require 2 inverters. Here I will get A bar B bar. Okay, I am using 1 AND gate here. Similarly here A bar B. So A bar I am getting from here. Another input is B. Similarly here A B bar. For last gate A B are the inputs. So here we require 4 AND gates, 2 inverters. Yeah, here 00 is the encoded. Correct. See, whatever here we are having, that is the coded information. Here, decoder, it will perform the decoding operation. Whatever the code available here. So, based on the coded information, at any time, a particular output will be 1. Because here, everything we have to represent in terms of zeros and ones only. Just look at this truth table and outputs. Is there any limitation is there? Or even you can observe the circuit diagram. Just consider this truth table and circuit diagram. Just analyze for each case. Is there any limitation is there? See here, if the coded information is 11, then D3 will be 1. Okay. If the coded information is 10, then D2 will be 1. If the coded information is 01, then D1 will be 1. Then, up to here there is no problem. Now, if the coded information is 00, then D0 will be 1. Then D0 will be 1. See, when the coded information 00 is available, that time D0 will be 1. Okay, remaining outputs will be 0. Right? Okay. Whenever you are not using this particular decoder circuit, that means what? You are not giving any inputs from externally. That time, in general, what you will expect at the output? Just like you went for the exam, you not attempted any question, whether you will expect 100 out of 100? No, right? Yeah. Here also, when you are not operating this particular circuit, that means you are not giving any inputs, that time here you should expect output as 0, right? But here, when you are not operating this particular circuit, that means your actual inputs are what? 00. That time all the outputs should be 0, right? But here, when the suppose if the code is there, say 00, that time my D0 should be 1. So there is some ambiguity. Okay. So when I'm not operating this particular circuit, that time also I'm getting output as 1, but I should get output as 0. But only when the coded information 00 is available here, that time only D0 has to be 1. Like that. So that means whenever I am not operating this particular circuit, okay, so that time all the outputs should be 0. Okay. When I am operating this particular circuit, based on the coded information available here, so accordingly the respective output will be 1. One of these outputs will be 1, remaining outputs will be 0s, like that. So for that, I will use one more signal that is called enable. Enable. Now I am giving one more signal, enable. When enable is 1, based on the coded information here available, okay, whatever the functionality we have discussed earlier, the same functionality will go. Okay, now when enable is 0, whatever may be the A and B inputs, when enable is 0, whatever may be the inputs of A and B, all the outputs should be 0. So here I am considering one more input, that is enable. So here for the time being, I have considered, see, here we are having AND gates, okay. To each AND gate, I have given one input signal, okay. If this particular value is 0, whatever may be the A and B inputs, all the outputs of these AND gates are zeros, right? So when enable is 1, based on the code available here, the respective output will be 1, right? So that means when enable is 0, that means I am disabling this particular circuit. Okay, when enable is 1, I am enabling this particular circuit. Based on the coded information available here, the respective output will be 1. One of these outputs will be 1, remaining will be 0, like that. So here for the time being, I have considered when enable is 1, this particular circuit I am enabling. Okay, if you want, you can make this particular circuit enabled when enable is 0 also. For that time, I will use one more inverter here. Okay, so here we will get one more input, that is enable. So when we consider enable signal, these are the outputs of the decoder. Okay, when we make enable equal to 1, write down the outputs once again. When enable equal to 1, D0 equal to A bar B bar, D1 equal to A bar B, D2 equal to AB bar, D3 equal to AB. What are these? Either minterms or maxterms? Minterms, right? So you can write M0, M1, M2, M3. Write down. If enable equal to 1, then the outputs of the decoder are nothing but the minterms. Okay. So that means, can we say decoder can be used for generating minterms? Yes. Okay. You can continue the statement. Hence, we can call the decoder as minterms generator. That means, when you are making enable is 1, whatever the outputs here we are getting, those are the minterms. So here we are getting minterms. Okay. In general, any Boolean function will be having sum of minterms. Right? We can represent any Boolean function as sigma m format. Sum of minterms. So whenever we want to implement the Boolean function which is represented in sigma m format. So from the output of the decoder, here if you make enable as 1, then we will get minterms. Okay. So whatever the minterms we require to be summed together. Okay. We will pass those minterms through OR gate. Okay. This is one of the real-time application of the decoder. We will get the minterms. So after getting the minterms, okay, we will connect the respective minterms through OR gate so that we will get the required Boolean functions like sigma m format. Okay. Write down the question. Implement half adder using 2 to 4 decoder. In half adder, we are having 2 inputs and 2 outputs. Okay. So for implementing half adder, how many 2 to 4 decoders we require? Yeah, 1 is sufficient. Because see here we are getting the minterms. When enable is 1, we are getting the minterms. Okay. So whatever may be the number of functions. So based upon that, we will use the required number of OR gates. Okay. We will connect the respective minterms as input for OR gate. We will get the Boolean functions. Implement half adder using 2 to 4 decoder and OR gates. Okay. Tell me the expressions for sum and carry of half adder. In terms of minterms, just look at the truth table of half adder. From that, we got the simplified expressions for sum and carry. Yeah, sum equal to AB bar plus A bar B. That means we can write that one as M1 plus M2. Okay, carry as M3. Okay, so here we got two minterms summed together. Here we are getting one minterm only. Okay, here A and B are the inputs. Whatever the decoder outputs D0 to D3, I am representing inside D0, D1, D2, D3, just for reference. Okay, here enable signal is there. Now we are making enable equal to 1, then outputs of the decoder are nothing but minterms. Okay, just for reference, here I am placing the minterms M0, M1, M2, M3. When enable equal to 1, outputs of the decoder are nothing but minterms. D0 is nothing but M0, D1 is M1, D2 is M2, D3 is M3. This is one of the application of decoder. When enable equal to 1, outputs of the decoder are nothing but minterms. So, with the help of these minterms and with the help of OR gates, we can implement any Boolean function. So, here sum expression is M1 plus M2. So, M1, M2, here I am getting, I will pass these two as the input for OR gate. Okay, next carry expression is M3. So here we don't require any logic gate. So straight away I am taking this. This is C. Okay, so S equal to M1 plus M2, C equal to M3. When enable equal to 1, output of the decoder are nothing but minterms. So based on the functions, okay, whatever the sum terms are, whatever the min terms are summed together, so accordingly we will connect those min terms as input of OR gate. Okay, here I don't require any logic gate because here C equal to M3, so straight away I can take. Next one is 3 to 8 decoder. Next one is 3 to 8 decoder. Just draw the block diagram. Here inputs are A, B, C. Three inputs A, B and C. Here we'll get 8 outputs D0 to D7. D0 to D7. And here we'll consider enable signal. Just write the outputs when enable is there. D0 equal to enable A bar, B bar, C bar. Here when all the bits are zeros. Okay, just write the outputs of the decoder. Enable. See, D0 will be 1 when enable is present and ABC inputs are zeros. That means enable and A bar, B bar, C bar. Okay, similarly, D1 will be 1 when enable is present and here code should be 001, right? So that means enable A bar, B bar, C. Enable A bar, B bar, C. So like that, last case. Just write 1 or 2 cases and last case. Here D7 will be 1 when enable is present and here the code should be 111. So that means enable A, B, C. Enable A, B, C. Similar to the 2 to 4 decoder, the functionality of 3 to 8 decoder functionality is similar. Okay, here enable signal we are having 3 inputs A, B, C. Outputs are D0 to D7, 8 outputs. Okay, so for 2 to 4 decoder we have considered when 00 is there, that time D0 will be 1. Okay, here we are considering 3 inputs. When all these 3 bits are zeros, that time here output will be 1. Okay, so that means D0 equal to enable A bar, B bar, C bar. Similarly here, if the code 001 is available, that time D1 will be 1. Okay, so that means D1 equal to enable A bar, B bar, C. Okay, just write for 2 cases. Similarly will be there for last case. Just write last case. D7 will be 1 when you are getting the code here 111. Okay, so enable ABC. Enable ABC. Okay, now you write the outputs when enable equal to 1. When enable equal to 1. If we want max terms, see here we are getting min terms. When enable is 1, here we are getting min terms, right? So, if you complement it, what it will be? Complement of min term is nothing but max terms, right? So, previously we have considered, if you remember, inside the circuit diagram we are having AND gates. Okay, instead of, see AND gate followed by inverter is nothing but what? NAND gate, right? So, in the place of AND gates, if you put NAND gates, here you will get active low outputs. Otherwise, here we are getting the min terms, okay? When enable is 1, here we are getting the min terms. Those min terms you pass through inverters, you will get max terms, like that. So, here enable equal to 1, substitute here. D0 will be A bar, B bar, C bar. That is nothing but M0. D1 equal to A bar, B bar. Just write for first 2 cases. Similarly, you will be having and write for the last case. D7 equal to ABC. That equal to M7. So that means when enable equal to 1, okay, that time 3 to 8 decoder will generate 8 min terms. M0 to M7. Write down the question. Implement full adder using 3 to 8 decoder and OR gates. For full adder, we are having sum and cout are the outputs. Inputs are AB and CN. Okay. Just look at the full adder truth table and the functions and then tell me the answer for this one. In terms of sigma m format. Sigma m format for sum and cout. Just go through the full adder we have discussed in the previous class and tell me the expressions for sum and cout. Yeah. Sum equal to 1247. Correct. Carry out. Cout 3567, right? Okay, now let us consider the 3 to 8 decoder and make enable equal to 1. Output of the decoder will nothing but min terms. Here inputs are AB and CN. Here I am making enable equal to 1. Whatever the outputs are there, I will mention here inside the decoder block and I will write outputs as min terms because we are making enable equal to 1. Okay, now for sum we are having M1 plus M2 plus M4 plus M7. Okay. So those min terms we will pass through OR gate. Inputs are 1247. Okay. Next, similarly you can use one more OR gate. Connect the respective min terms as the inputs. Here inputs are 3567. 5, 6 and 7. 3567. See, for 6, you will be having the input 110. Right? 1 plus 1 is 2. Right? Number of 1s is 2. That means In binary, how will you represent? 1, 0. Cout is 1, sum will be 0. Just look at the truth table of full adder. You are having A, B, C in are the inputs. There you are having Cout and sum as the outputs. For certain combination of inputs, output will be, suppose you can see individually, individual function. Okay. For some combination of inputs, output is 1. For other combinations, output is 0. Okay. Here we are considering the minterms. That means for which combination of inputs we are getting output as 1. Just tell me for which combination of the inputs you are getting Cout as 1. See, whatever the input you are having, A, B, C in. Okay. Just look at, consider the decimal equivalent of that one. So there you will get M0, M1, M2, M3 like that. Okay. So for whichever input combinations you are getting output as 1, I will consider required those minterms like that. Okay. So in the exams, they will give one particular decoder. Okay. There you are having outputs, right? So they will pass those outputs as input for some logic gates and they will ask what is the output. Just for easy understanding, whatever the adders we have implemented earlier, okay, we are considering that one, we are implementing. Just for easy understanding. Okay, in the exam, you will get, they will give any decoder, okay, they will pass some of the outputs as input for some logic gates. They will ask what is the output function here. Either in terms of sigma m format or simplified format like that. For decoder, at any time, a particular output will be 1. Only one output will be 1, other outputs will be 0. Because based on the code we are getting, accordingly to the respective code, the particular output is 1. At a time, two outputs cannot be 1. Next topic, implementation of higher order decoders using lower order decoders. Implementation of higher order decoders using lower order decoders. See, previously we have considered 2 to 4 decoder. Internally you are having AND gates. Okay. So there we are having 4 AND gates. Similarly, if you implement 3 to 8 decoder, there also you require, how many AND gates you require? 8 AND gates, right? But the number of inputs to the AND gates will increase. Whereas for 2 to 4 decoder, okay, if you consider enable also as the input, then you require 3 inputs for each AND gate. Whereas for 3 to 8 decoder, you require 4 inputs along with the enable. Okay, but the similar structure only going on, right? You are having AND gates, inverters combination only, right? But as we are going for higher orders, we require separate hardware circuit. But internally, if you look at the circuit diagram, you are having AND gates, inverter combination only, right? So that's why whenever we want to implement higher order decoder, we can use lower order decoder. Because once if you implement say 2 to 4 decoder, with the help of that one, you can implement 3 to 8 decoder and 4 to 16 decoder like that. Because we already implemented one particular decoder, so that circuit diagram is available with you. You consider this, that is the one single block, okay? And with the help of that 2 to 4 decoder, you can implement higher order decoders like that. So here we'll discuss implementation of higher order decoders using lower order decoders. Write on the question, the minimum number of 2 to 4 decoders required for implementing a 4 to 16 decoder. The minimum number of 2 to 4 decoders required for implementing a 4 to 16 decoder is dash. You'll get the questions like this in the exam. Okay. First here, let us see the conventional approach. Okay. And then I will mention the shortcut method. Okay. You can follow that shortcut method later. Okay. In the exam, you can follow the shortcut method. Here, you'll be having two variety of questions. For both the models, we'll discuss the conventional approach first. Okay. So here we want to implement 4 to 16 decoder using 2 to 4 decoder. Okay. Here higher order decoder is 4 to 16, lower order decoder is 2 to 4. Right. So for a 4 to 16 decoder, number of outputs is 16. For a 4 to 16 decoder, number of outputs will be 16, D0 to D15. Whereas for 2 to 4 decoder, number of outputs will be 4. Okay. So now let us calculate the number of lower order decoders required at the last stage. See, you want to implement 4 to 16 decoder, that means you require 16 outputs at the last stage. Okay, but I am using 4 output decoder, right? So first I will calculate the number of 2 to 4 decoders or lower order decoders required at the last stage. Okay, so here outputs is 16, number of outputs required is 16. Here we are using 4 output decoder. So how much? 16 by 4 is 4. That means we will use 4 2 to 4 decoders at the last stage. Okay. Each decoder will be having 2 inputs and 4 outputs. Okay. So here inside I am representing D0 to D3. For each decoder, you will be having 4 outputs D0 to D3. For a 4 to 16 decoder, you will be having 16 outputs D0 to D15, right? So those outputs I am writing external. D0, D1, D2, D3, like that up to D15. Okay. So if you are having 4 to 16 decoder, here you will be having 16 outputs D0 to D15. Okay. Here we are considering 4 2 to 4 decoder. For each decoder, you will be having 4 outputs. I have represented inside for our reference. First, I have calculated the number of lower order decoders required at the last stage. So that means each decoder requires one enable signal, right? So here number of enables is 4. Number of enables is 4. Okay. And just look at the lower order decoder which we are using. Here number of outputs is 4. If the number of enables required and the number of outputs here, what are the decoder we are using? If both are matching, then I will use one more 2 to 4 decoder just one stage prior to this. Here first I have calculated the number of lower order decoders required at the last stage. Okay. So we require 4 2 to 4 decoders. That means each decoder requires one enable signal. Right. So here we require total 4 enable signals. Okay. 4 enable signals we require. And we are using 4 output decoder. Okay. If the number of enables required and the number of outputs which we are using, if both are matching, then I will use one more 2 to 4 decoder. Here now what I will do, I will give D0 as input for this, D1 as input for this, D2 as enable for this, D3 as enable for this, like that. Okay, so here I am getting 4 outputs and each output I have given as enable for each decoder. D0 as enable for this one, D1 as enable for this, D2 as enabled for this, D3 as enabled for this. Okay, so if you are having 4 to 16 decoder, for the time being I am considering ABCD are the inputs for 4 to 16 decoder. For 4 to 16 decoder, you will be having 4 inputs ABCD, right? And D0 to D15, 16 outputs, right? So here I will place AB are the inputs and see, from input to output you are having 2 stages, right? This is one stage, this is another stage. Okay. Here I will give AB as the inputs and for all these decoders I will give CD as the inputs. From input to output you are having 2 stages. Okay. For a 4 to 16 decoder you will be having 4 inputs AB, CD. Okay. Here I am giving AB as the inputs and for all these decoders I am giving CD as the inputs. Okay. Now if you look at the broader, okay, what else block diagram here we are having, considered as single block. Okay. We are having 4 inputs AB, CD. And 16 outputs D0 to D15. 16 outputs D0 to D15. Suppose if my code ABCD, okay, if say 1010 is available for a 4 to 16 decoder, when you are having enable signal, okay, when you got the enable signal, that time if ABCD code is 1010, then what will be, which output will be 1 for a 4 to 16 decoder? Yeah, 10, correct. D10 is the 1, correct. So now I am placing the same code here. Here I am having 10. AB is 10. AB is 10. Next, CD is 10. Okay, now see here we are having 2 to 4 decoder. I am having the code as 10. When the code is 10, which output will be 1? D2. D2 is 1. Remaining 3 outputs are zeros. That means here D0 is 0. That means this particular decoder is disabled. When this is disabled, all these outputs are zeros. Similarly, D1 is 0. This particular decoder is disabled. So all these outputs are zeros. Similarly, D3 is 0. So outputs of this particular decoder also 0. Right? So only the third decoder, this decoder is getting enabled. Is it clear? When we are having the code 10, D2 is 1, remaining outputs are zeros. Okay. So I have given the outputs of the decoder as enabled for next stage decoders. Okay. So that means what? Here D2 is 1. That means only this particular decoder is getting enabled. remaining all the other decoders are disabled. So that means other outputs are zeros. Now, here enable signal you got. Now the code is 10. That means here, when you are having 10, D2 will be 1. That D2 is nothing but your D10. So that means for a 4 to 16 decoder, when you are having the code 1010, that time D10 should be 1. D10 will be 1. Remaining will be zeros. You can analyze for any case. If you are having any doubt, you can ask. Here I have given the conventional approach just for understanding. Okay, in the exam, if you are getting the question like this, okay. So here, first we will calculate the number of lower order decoders required at the last stage. So first I have calculated that one. Okay. You can write down number of lower order decoders required at the last stage or output stage is equal to number of outputs of required decoder divided by number of outputs of given decoder. First we will calculate the number of lower order decoders required at the last stage, that equal to number of outputs of required decoder divided by number of outputs of given decoder. Here we want to implement 4 to 16 decoder, that means we require 16 outputs. Here in the numerator you will get 16. Okay. Given decoder, that means using 2 to 4 decoder. Here number of outputs is 4. So here we'll substitute 16 by 4 equal to 4. First we'll calculate the number of lower order decoders required at the last stage. After that, so whatever the number you are getting, okay, that number you will check, that means you require that many enables, right? So in this case I require number of enables is 4 and I am using 4 output decoder only. If these two are matching, I will use one more decoder. Here you will be having two variety of question. Here in this case number of enables required and the number of outputs which you are using a particular decoder, both are matching. Okay. In other case we require only two enables. Okay. For that case I will discuss next. Okay. Next you can make another point. If the number of enables required at the last stage is equal to the number of outputs of given decoder, then we will use one more decoder just one stage prior to it. That means here in this case we got 4. Okay, after that, since we got 4, that means we require 4 enables and we are using 4 output decoder only. So I will use one more decoder. So 4 plus 1 is 5. So we require 5 2 to 4 decoders for implementing a 4 to 16 decoder. Okay, so first we'll determine the number of lower order decoders required at the last stage. Okay, that means from here we'll get the number of enables. And if the number of enables and number of outputs, if both are matching, then we will use one more decoder like that. Okay, you remember this formula. Now, with the help of this one, tell me the answer for this question. Write down the question. The minimum number of 3 to 8 decoders required for implementing a 6 to 64 decoder is dash. Yeah, 9 is the correct answer. So here, first we'll calculate the number of lower order decoders required at the last stage. Here number of outputs is 64, here number of outputs is 8. So 64 by 8, that is 8. So that means we require 8 enables. Okay, so here we require 8 enables. We are using 8 output decoder only. If both are matching, then I will use one more decoder, right? So that means 8 plus 1, that equal to 9. Okay, so for these type of questions, first we'll determine the number of lower order decoders required at the last stage. That means that many enables are required. If the number of enables and number of outputs both are matching, I will use one more decoder. Okay, so answer is 9. Next question. The minimum number of 2 to 4 decoders and inverters required for implementing a 3 to 8 decoder is dash. You have to find out the minimum number of 2 to 4 decoders and inverters required for implementing a 3 to 8 decoder. So that means here we are implementing a 3 to 8 decoder using 2 to 4 decoders and inverter, right? So here also we'll follow the same procedure. So here first we'll determine the number of lower order decoders required at the last stage. Here number of outputs is 8, but we are using 4 output decoders. That means 8 by 4, that equal to 8 by 4 equal to 2. That means here we will use 2 to 4 decoders at the last stage. Okay, here in this case we require 2 enables. We require 2 enables. So when we require 2 enables, that time we can use one inverter. With the help of inverter, we can make one particular decoder as enable, other decoder as disable, like that. Here, if you want, you can use one more decoder also. But instead of, see, inside 2 to 4 decoder, you will be having 4 AND gates and 2 inverters. But instead of having that entire block diagram, just with the help of inverter, we can make enable or disable one particular decoder, right? So when it is possible, then we can use inverter, right? Answer for this question is 2 2 to 4 decoders and 1 inverter. See here, we require 2 2 to 4 decoders at the last stage. Okay. So for a 3-to-8 decoder, we'll be having 8 outputs D0 to D7. D0 to D7. Right? And for a 3-to-8 decoder, inputs I am assuming as ABC. 3 inputs ABC. Okay. So here just observe. At the last stage, we require 2 enables. We require 2 enables. Here I am giving A as the input, here I will give BC as the inputs. BC as the inputs. Just like the previous case. See, here we are having 3 inputs, A, B, C. BC I have given as the inputs here, A is the input here. Okay. Now, suppose I am having the code ABC as say 101. For 3-to-8 decoder, if you are having 101 as the input, okay, then which output will be 1? You can connect like this. Okay. When you are having the coded information 101, then for a 3-to-8 decoder, which output will be 1? D5, right? So here I am giving A value is 1, BC value says 01. Here also 01. Okay. Here input is 1, right? So that means this particular decoder is getting enabled. Okay. What about here? Enable is 0. Enable is 0. That means outputs of the decoder are zeros here. Okay. Here we are getting enable signal. What is the code here? 01. That means D1 will be 1. That D1 is nothing but your D5. Right? So here at the last stage, we require only 2 enables. When we require only 2 enables, that means when this is enabled, this should be disabled. Or when this is disabled, this should be enabled. So in order to make one of the decoder has enabled, just with the help of inverter, we can make it enabled, right? If you want, you can use one more decoder, 2 to 4. There, we can give one of the input as grounded. So accordingly, you can give one particular output as here as the input. But why we require unnecessarily one more decoder? When you are able to implement with the help of one particular inverter sufficient, why we have to go unnecessarily for one more decoder, right? So answer for this question is, we require 2 2 to 4 decoders and 1 inverter. We require 2 2 to 4 decoders, and here we require 2 enables, right? So that's why we are using 1 inverter. Yeah, okay. Suppose if inverter is not there. Okay. See, here you'll get the statements. Okay. List of the statements. You have to choose the correct answer. For this question, you require 2 2 to 4 decoders and 1 inverter. Suppose you don't have inverter, suppose you want to make it operate with 2 to 4 decoder, right? Now you can draw the one more 2 to 4 decoder. This won't be at the last stage, this will be here only. Okay, here only. Here you will be having enable signal. Here you are having 2 inputs, but for a 3-to-8 decoder, we will be having only 3 inputs. Among which we have given 2 inputs here, right? So we are having only one more input, A. So here you can choose either this input or this input as A. Okay, so for the time being, I am choosing this one as A, this one as grounded. You can choose either this one ground, you can apply A here, there is no issue. This is like, if you want, for the time being, I am representing like A1, A0. This is the MSP, this is the LSP. Now, here when enable is 1, okay. When enable is 1, here it is already 0. It is grounded, that means 0, right? So, here if I am giving A value 0 for the time being, okay, if A is 0, then what will happen? When 0,0 is there, which output will be 1? D0 will be 1. Okay, next. If I am giving D0 is 1. Okay, next. If I am giving A value is 1, then which output will be 1? So, I will give D0 as enabled for one of these and D2 as enabled for another, like that. When A is 0, 0 bar is 1. So, according to the requirement, I will connect one of these two as enable for here, another one is enable for. Here, if you observe, when enable is, when A is 1, that time I am getting enable here. That means, when A is 1, here D2 is 1. So I will connect D2 as here. Okay. Similarly, when A is 0, that time D0 is 1. So I will connect here. Well, if you give 0 here, 0 bar will be 1. Like that. Is it clear? So here we are having two varieties of questions. One variety is number of enables required will match to the number of outputs of the particular decoder. Okay, what are the decoder we are using? To that number of outputs will match. In that case, we will use one more decoder. Okay, other case is we require two enables. That time I will use inverter. With the help of inverter, we can make one particular decoder as enable, other decoder as disable. Like that. Okay, write down the question. Next one. The minimum number of 3-tier decoders and inverters required for implementing a 4-to-16 decoder is dash. Yeah, we require 2 3-tier decoders and 1 inverter. Here number of outputs is 16, 16 by 8 is 2. So we require 2 3-tier decoders. Since we require 2 enables, so I will use 1 inverter.